Welcome back to another video. Today we're going to be doing a review on the HP Elitebook 2760p laptop / tablet computer. We are going to be grading this product in four categories: build quality, features, performance, and price, and then telling you guys if you should go buy it. So without further ado, let's begin. So the first category is build quality. Now this configuration of the laptop costed $1,700 in 2011, so you better hope it's built well, and it is. The lid and the bottom of the machine are made of what is called magnesium and aluminum hybrid, and the palm rest is made of solid brushed aluminum. These Elitebooks have a reputation for being tough, and this is no exception. The magnesium and hybrid material for the lid and bottom gives the laptop a soft touch. Only downside is that scratches on the lid are a lot more visible, and the corners get cracked a lot according to the used models of this notebook on eBay. So for build quality, I will give it a 9 out of 10. So the next category is features. For the I/O, we get three USB 2.0 ports, and one of them is a charging port that allows you to charge your phone while the machine is off. Unfortunately, there are no USB 3 ports on this machine. We also get Ethernet, VGA out, 56K modem, FireWire, a wireless on-off switch, a browser shortcut button, an SD card reader, 3.5mm headphone jack, and a smart card reader. There's also a webcam and a light for lighting up the keyboard while typing at night. So let's talk about tablet mode. To get into tablet mode, you have to swivel the screen as far as you can and then push it down until it attaches to the base. Tablet mode is actually pretty usable. While it is hard to tap on small objects with your fingers, you can use the pen to do that, and I find myself using the pen more while in tablet mode than my fingers. One problem with the tablet mode is the display. The resolution of the display is only 1280 by 800, and while it doesn't look that bad on a small screen, there is this ugly black bezel combined with the silver bezel around the screen. Maybe the black bezel is there to put your fingers on the display without touching anything, but I personally would prefer the screen to fill in the black bezel part. Viewing angles are okay and are far from the worst, and the display gets bright enough for use outside. The battery's kinda eh, maybe it's because it's a 9-year-old battery, but I get about 1.5 hours of battery life while web browsing in high performance mode, and in power saving mode I get about 3 hours. And thanks to this machine's i5 CPU, even this machine in low power mode is very usable thanks to the SSD added to the system. The keyboard in this machine is very good, and definitely better than most keyboards on newer machines. The webcam and microphone aren't that great, but usable. So this is the webcam and microphone quality test. As you can see here, we have a nice little Dell Dimension. I don't know how well you can see that, as I can't see what I'm recording since I have the screen. But I mean, it's pretty bad. But I mean, it's probably definitely better than some of the Chromebooks that the schools sometimes give people. Overall, I give it a 9 out of 10 as well. So to show the performance of this machine, I decided to show some benchmarks and gaming tests on this machine. The full specs are an Intel Core i5-2520M CPU, 5 gigs of RAM upgraded from 4 gigs, and a 64 gig SSD, Intel integrated graphics, which is the biggest letdown of this machine, especially since it was once a $1,700 laptop. So let's begin the benchmarks. So for performance, I give it about a 4 out of 5. The integrated graphics aren't good for gaming, but for doing basic things like web browsing and stuff that you would normally do at a school, it is a good option. So what about pricing? Well, these things range anywhere from $50 to $120 depending on how good of a condition you want yours to be. For $50, you can get one that has either a lot of scratches or cracks, or for towards $120, you can get one that's refurbished and in way better condition than if you were to pay $50. So would I recommend these? I would say yes, if you're going to be using it as a laptop for school or as an everyday web browsing machine. But if you're going to be using this for gaming or anything like video or photo editing, I would pass on it. There are a lot cheaper options that aren't touchscreen but have better performance. So hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, definitely like and subscribe. This is the first kind of like quote unquote high quality thing that I've done, and I was in the process of moving my setup as I was recording this video, so yeah, hope you guys enjoyed this video. More laptop videos coming soon. I ordered, I think it was like 4 or 5 untested laptops, and I'm going to see how many of those I can get to work, and the ones that don't work, I can make a video on trying to repair. So, see you guys next time.